For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Report 7 from your Sample Files folder. You already know how to print all of the cells in a worksheet, but sometimes you'll want to only print a selection of cells from a worksheet. Excel provides two ways to do this. The first method is applicable when the requirement is a one-off. In other words, the next time you print, the entire worksheet will be printed in the usual way. The second method involves setting a print area. If you then save the worksheet, the defined print area will remain, unless you later clear the print area. In this lesson, you'll explore both methods. Let's begin by displaying the worksheet in normal view, if you're not already in it. You do that using the three view tabs at the bottom right of the screen. This is Page Layout View, and this is Normal View. Imagine now that you need to print a listing for all of January's sales, and of course, this worksheet contains transactions for January, February, and March. To do that, I'll select all of the transactions for January. That is cells A8 to J93. I'll now click File on the ribbon, and then Print. And on the left-hand side of the dialog, notice there's a Print Active Sheets setting. I'm going to click the drop-down now and change that to Print Selection. I'll just click the Zoom to Page button so that I can see things more clearly, and you can see that now only the January sales are being printed. But if you were to save, close and reopen the workbook, you'd then print the entire worksheet again. Let's just prove that. I'll click the Back button, I'll close Excel, and then I'll open Excel again, and once again open the Sales Report 7 sample file. And if I then click File tab on the ribbon and Print, you can see that once again I'm printing the entire worksheet. In other words, the instruction to only print the selected cells is lost when the worksheet is closed and reopened. But consider the case of a worksheet where you will only ever want to print a selected range. In this case, you'd like the print settings to be saved with the workbook. And we can do that by defining a print area. I'll click the Back button to return to the Excel worksheet. And once again, I'll select January transactions. That is cells A8 to J93. I'm now going to define cells A8 to J93 as a print area. To do that, I click the Page Layout button on the ribbon and in the Page Setup group, Print Area, and then Set Print Area. And notice that a small grey line has now appeared around the print area to indicate that only these cells will be printed. Let's test that now with a print preview. So I click the File tab on the ribbon, print from the left-hand bar. I'll click the Zoom to Page button to see things a little more clearly, and you can see that only the January transactions are now printed. The difference between setting a print area and printing the selected cells, as we did before, is that this print area will be saved with the worksheet. Let's prove that now. I'll click the Back button, and then I'll click the Save button on the Quick Access toolbar. Then I'll close Sales Report 7, and I'll reopen it. And then I'll print. File on the ribbon, print on the left-hand menu bar. I'll zoom to page to see things more clearly, and you can see that I'm still only printing the cells in the defined print area. I'll now click the Back button to return to Excel. Sometimes you'll define a print area and then your requirement will change and you need to clear the print area so that you can once again print out the entire worksheet. To do that, I'll click the Page Layout tab on the ribbon and in the Page Setup group, Print Area, and then clear print area. And you can see that the grey line around the print area has now gone. And if I click File, Print, you can see that I'm now printing out the entire worksheet once again. I'll now click the Back button to return to normal view. Print areas don't have to be contiguous. That means you can print several different sections from your worksheet at the same time. Non-contiguous ranges were covered in depth in Lesson 2.7. Let's now implement the requirement to print all of January sales, along with all of March's sales, but not to print February sales. To do this, I'll begin by selecting January sales, as I did before. That would be cells A8 to J93. Then, as before, I'll click Page Layout on the ribbon, and in the Page Setup group, Print Area, and then I'll click Set Print Area. And as before, you can see that a light grey line has appeared around cells A8 to J93, the January transactions. Now I'll move down to the March transactions and select those. That would be cells A174 to J249. Now I'll click Page Setup on the ribbon and Print Area once again. And notice there's an option to Add to Print Area. So I'll click Add to Print Area. And notice that a grey line has now appeared around cells A174 to J249. And I still have a grey line around my January transactions. I'll now click File tab on the ribbon and print from the left-hand menu bar. And notice that I'm now printing January transactions along with March transactions, but I'm not printing February transactions. Let's clear the print area now by clicking the Back button to return to normal view, Page Layout on the ribbon, Print Area, and Clear Print Area. And to end this lesson, I'll just click the Save button on the Quick Access toolbar to put the sample file back into the state it was in at the start of the lesson. And you've now completed Lesson 7.10, Print Only Part of a Worksheet.